Oke, Nabila.
Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, how are you today, class?
I'm fine.
I'm fine. Thank you, Miss.
Okay. Before starting our learning today, let's pray together by reciting Al-Fatihah. Al-Fatihah begin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Okay, enough. Okay, today we are going to learn about analytical exposition text. Has anyone of you heard of analytical exposition text?
Not yet, miss.
Okay. Today we are going to learn about the definition and social function of analytical exposition text, the general structure, and language features. First of all, analytical exposition text is the part of exposition text. There are two parts of exposition text, hortatory and analytical. Today we are going to learn about the analytical exposition text. First of all, the definition and social function. Can you read the text or is it not clear?
Miss, can you make it zoom little? Okay. Okay. Sip.
First is the definition of analytical exposition text. As you can see in here, I have highlighted, yeah, here with the yellow part. It is a text which describes the author's opinion about a certain issue. So when you are writing a text and you are describing your opinion about a certain issue or phenomenon that is happening around you, it is called analytical exposition text. Yeah. And the social function of analytical exposition text is to persuade the reader or to convince them that the idea is important, that it is important to highlight the idea that we bring or we convey in the text. Anybody knows what is the meaning of persuade? Persuade. Farel, can you tell me the meaning of persuade? Do you know?
Paksaan, miss, atau dorongan.
Okay, dorongan. Yeah, dorongan is correct, but it's more like meyakinkan, to persuade, untuk meyakinkan the reader that the idea is important. Yeah, so we make sure that the reader knows that the thing that we talk about in the text is important. Is that clear or do I need to repeat my explanation?
Maybe you should repeat once again, miss.
Okay. So, the definition of analytical exposition text is a text that describes the author's opinion. Yeah? It is talking about the author's opinion about certain issue or a certain matter. Yeah? And the function is to convince the reader that it is an important matter. Is that clear?
Okay, miss.
Okay. The next is the general structure of analytical exposition text. So, the text consists of three main structures. The first is thesis, Second is argument. And the third is reiteration. If this is too difficult for you, you can say it is consists of introduction, body, and conclusion. It is still the same, yeah? We just use different diction. The first is thesis. Thesis is the part where we introduce the topic and indicate our position. For example, we are writing about corruption. And in the thesis part, in the introduction part, we state our position regarding the issue, regarding corruption. For example, we are contradictive about corruption. We state it in the thesis. We state it in the introduction. The second part is the body or the argument. In this part, we explain the arguments to support our position as the writer. So in this part, in the argument part, we explain why our position is right, why our position is something that is considerate about the issue. The last part is reiteration or the conclusion. The conclusion is where we restate our position regarding the issue. So it is like we strengthening our opinions and our position about the issue we are talking about. Am I too fast? Can you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next is The next is the language features of analytical exposition text. Yeah, here we see there are many features in an analytical exposition text. There are 11 features available in analytical exposition text. However, when we are writing an analytical exposition text, we don't have to include every single one of the features in the text. So 3 is enough, even 1 is enough. Yeah, we don't have to write everything in here in our analytical exposition text. This is just some of the features that is usually present in an analytical exposition text. Yeah, we can use a relational process, passive sentence, internal conjunction. You can screenshot this if you want. I will give you time to take notes or screenshot this part because it is too much. Should I explain one by one or is it enough? Should I explain one by one?
No, please.
Okay. This is just some features, yeah. You don't have to write everything in here when you are writing an analytical exposition text. Even one is just enough. Okay. Next, I have an example of a short analytical exposition text. Iqbal, can you read this for me? Can you read this for the class?
Yes, miss. Pardon.
Iqbal, can you read this?
I can hear you clearly. Can you repeat?
Can you read the text?
Oh, okay. Okay, miss. So the children will have at school. I believe that you should always wear a hat at school when you are playing outside to stop you from getting sunburned. Firstly, if you don't wear a hat, you will get sunburned and the sunburn is painful. Secondly, sunburn could lead to cancer. Sunburn can lead to health problems later in life. Many older people suffer from skin cancer, which can kill them. In my opinion, all school students should wear hats.
Okay, thank you, Iqbal.
You're
welcome. Now, from the text, we can see that there are colors in the text. These colors are supposed to part the thesis, argument, and reiteration of the text. Okay, you can see the note that I write underneath the text. The text that is written in black is the thesis. Yeah, we read it in here. I believe that you should always wear a hat at school when you are playing outside to stop you from getting sunburned. Yeah, this is the thesis. Thesis is where the writers state their position. Yeah, so the writer believe that students should always wear hat at school. Okay, then the red text. Yeah, firstly, if you don't wear a hat, you will get sunburn, and the sunburn is painful. This is the first argument. The argument explains the writer's position. Yeah, it explains the thesis. It explains the introduction. Okay, then we read the green text. Secondly, sunburn could lead into skin cancer. Sunburn can lead to health problems later in life. Many older people suffer from skin cancer, which can kill them. So, this is also the argument. We can write 2 arguments, 3 arguments, 4 arguments. We can write as many arguments as we want. Yeah. So, the red and the green one is the argument of the text. It still strengthens the thesis. The last one, the blue one, in my opinion, all school students should wear hats. It is the conclusion or the reiteration. This is where the writer restate their position about the issue, about their belief, about a certain matter. Is that clear? Should I explain one more time?
Clear, Miss.
Okay, if that's clear, we are heading to the conclusion of today's lesson. Okay, the first one is the definition. What is the definition of analytical exposition text? Analytical exposition text is a text that elaborates or describes the writer's ideas about the phenomenon surrounding. It describes the writer's idea. Okay, and then the purpose. The purpose is to persuade or convince or make sure that the idea is important. Yeah, meyakinkan pembaca bahwa ide yang disampaikan adalah sesuatu yang penting. Yeah. The general structure consists of thesis, argument, and reiteration. The language features, yeah, we can use simple present tense, modal adverbs, modal verbs, contrastive, yeah, and many other features. We don't have to include every single one of the features in the text, yeah. It's enough, even if just one, it is enough. Okay, is that clear? Do you want to take notes from this screen?
Yes, ma'am.
I will give you time to take note and screenshot, yeah. Okay. Do you have any question about today's lesson? Because if you don't have any question, I will ask you the question.
Okay, ma'am.
Is that clear?
Clear, Miss.
Okay. Before closing our lesson today, I want to ask you, Iqbal, what is the definition of analytical exposition text? The definition? Explain with your language, it's okay.
The definition analytical exposition is a text that elaborate a test this elaborate sorry the definition analytical expression is a text that elaborate
Yeah.
Well. Hello, Iqbal. Are you there? Okay, the next person, Nabila. Give the question to another student.
Okay, Farel, are you there?
Okay, Faras.
Faras, are you there?
Ya, Tania.
Tania, are you there?
Okay, please turn on off all your cam. Voila. Paras, turn on your cam. Parel. Paras. Will, sorry, koneksi terputus. Okay, kelas Nabila.
Okay, I think that's enough for our learning today. Thank you for attending the class. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. There is not the homework.
Actually, there is, sir. But
okay. Thank you, Nabila. Please close your screen.
Yeah.
Share. What the application that is used, Nabila?
What, sir?
Bill. What is the application when you screen your presentation? When you share your presentation?
Microsoft PowerPoint, sir.
Microsoft PowerPoint, okay. But why in my screen when you present the presentation, your cam is closed? Okay, have you understood how to screen your presentation in Google Meet?
I am using my phone, sir, because if I use my laptop, the connection is unstable.
Okay, I see. I think you use your laptop. Okay. Nabila, thank you for your presentation. But when you explain about the exposition, okay, you have to be careful because there is the thin difference between Portatory and analytical. Okay, your explanation, your definition, your structure is okay. But when you give the example of text, your text is portatory exposition. Because there is the word should in your text. Should the student use have, ya, judulnya ya? Tadi ya, biasanya kalau should or should not itu digunakan untuk hortatory exposition. Contoh, beda tipis nih, antara membuang sampah dan tempat sampah. School should prepare the dustbin in every class. Ini adalah yang disebut dengan hortatory exposition. Tapi kalau dustbin in every class can make the school clean. Itu baru analytical exposition. Padahal bicaranya sama-sama tentang pentingnya tempat sampah. Tapi kalau sudah ada bahasa should, harus melakukan sesuatu atau tidak melakukan sesuatu, itu namanya hortatory exposition. Kalau bahasa Inggrisnya begini. Sekolah harus menyediakan tempat sampah di setiap kelas. Itu hortatory exposition. Tapi kalau analytical exposition bahasanya begini. Ketersediaan tempat sampah di masing-masing kelas dapat membuat lingkungan bersih. Itu juga sama menjadi analytical exposition. Padahal objek pembicaraannya sama-sama tentang tempat sampah. Gitu ya. Oke. Ini memang yang terjadi bukan sekali saja. Terjadi penjelasan ketika, jangankan mungkin yang mahasiswa yang sudah mengajar pun kadang-kadang masih mahasiswa membedakan mana hortatory exposition, mana analytical exposition. Hortatory kelas berapa tuh, Bill? Kalau hortatory?
Sama kayaknya, Pak, kelas 12 juga.
Cuman beda semester ya?
Iya.
Ya, nanti tinggal membedakan saja, karena biasanya dua hal itu kalau dulu zaman ujian nasional pasti muncul. Antara hortatory dan analytical exposition, gitu ya. Kemudian karena tadi kalau ngelihat saya ngelihat RPP punya Nabila itu sudah hebat banget, Bill. Pertemuan pertama bisa membuat sebuah kalimat, sebuah teks hortatory exposition ya di RPP-nya ya.
Iya, Nabila, Pak.
Gagah itu. Itu harusnya pertemuan yang terakhir. Atau pertemuan yang ketiga dan keempat. Karena yang pertama itu, jangan lu sampai membuat dulu, Bill. Bisa menjawab pertanyaan yang berhubungan dari teks exposition. Gitu aja dulu. Jadi Nabila ngasih teks, mereka bisa nanya, bisa-bisa menjawab, mana yang disebut dengan isunya, gitu ya. Mana yang disebut dengan reiteration-nya, mana yang disebut dengan explanation-nya, itu sudah gagah untuk pertemuan yang pertama. Bahkan kalau Nabila mau membahas tentang simple present tense, adverb of apa tadi? Language future-nya itu? Adverb of manner apa? Yang grammar-nya yang dibahas dalam language future-nya tadi?
Oh iya, modal adverb.
Ya, modal adverb yang kayak gitu. Nah, mau membahas itu aja dulu, fokusnya ke sana, itu nggak masalah. Karena dengan language feature itu adalah modal untuk siswa untuk mengerjakan tugas akhirnya nanti. Karena tugas akhirnya harus sampai dengan bisa membuat sebuah teks. Begitu kan ya? Jadi, kalau emang saya mintanya sih tadi, Nabil minta satu RPP doang ya. Tapi biasanya satu KD itu, Bill, 3.8, 3. berapa sih, Bill? Itunya? RPP-nya
3.1
ya?
1, nah, Pak.
Biasanya analog exposition ini disampaikan sampai dengan 4 kali pertemuan. Jadi harus direncanakan tuh. Jangan sampai sudah 2 kali pertemuan Nabila sudah kehabisan materi. Gitu ya. Jadi dibuatlah yang begini di time allocation-nya, buat di situ. Berarti kalau 3-4 kali pertemuan itu berarti harusnya 8 kali 45 menit ya. Karena satu pertemuan hanya 2 jam kan, 2 kali 45 menit.
Ganti oli.
Ya. gitu ya. Oke, okay. Bill ya, thank you. Mulai ngajar SMA 2 kapan, Bill?
Iya, Pak. Kenapa, Pak?
Mulai ngajar SMA 2 kapan?
Kurang tahu, Pak. Belum ada ini.
Oh, gitu.
Tadi baru dikasih tahu sama Bu Hikmah nomor Pak Rifkinya.
Nah, nanti dengan saya diskusinya, Bill ya. Saya guru pamong Nabila nanti di mana di SMA 2 Rakas gitu. Oke. Okay. Thank you Nabila. Good job. Mana lagi nih? Siap. Pak Rel, ini yang udah presentasi semua, Bill. Rel, buka dong camnya, Rel. Ini bolos nih. Ini namanya Bill, ini bolos era revolusi 4.0 begini. Jadi zoom masuk iya, kemudian kameranya dimatiin, suaranya hilang. Itu sudah bolos namanya. Nanti Nabila akan menemukan ini di sekolah. Di sekolah nanti pasti, pasti pada begini. Ketika Nabila ngoceh aja kan, nggak taunya siswanya kayak model gini nih. Ada masuk, tapi orangnya udah nggak ada di depan device-nya. Udah kemana tahu itu bolos 4.0 itu. Mana nih pilih yang lainnya? Astagfirullahaladzim.
Coba saya hubungi dulu Pak sebentar.
Assalamualaikum Pak, maaf tadi saya habis asaran bentar Pak.
Ya siap, nggak apa-apa Pak Rel. Tadi belum asar nih Rel. Ini mau kalau mau presentasi lagi, Tania ada di situ nggak Rel? Ada di pondok?
Ada nggak sih guys? Tania guys?
Ini lagi saya hubungin Pak, lagi saya coba hubungin.
Kalau Gagas, Rel, ada di situ biasanya di kamar Pak Rel biasanya.
Iya Pak, Gagas di, lagi nyambungin wifi lagi Pak, tadi putus-putus.
Udah pakai itu aja berarti Rel, pakai wifi Pak Rel aja, presentasinya di situ aja pakai laptop Pak Rel.
Bentar lagi Pak katanya Pak.
Oh, bentar jadi lagi.
Sini aja guys.
Sini aja
bisa. Di laptop lu aja. Di laptop dari laptop dari laptopnya Gagas aja Pak katanya Pak.
Oh gitu.
Iya.
Kalau masuk terus Rel. Pak laptop Gagas kalau masuk terus dari tadi.
Kurang masuk terus guys.
Itu mikrofonnya Pak agak gimana gitu.
Bisa nih kayaknya. Coba ya. Baik. Bisa guys.
Nih. Siap. Para